Today we're going to talk about how to flash an ISO image to a USB drive. Now you can use this to make a bootable USB with a new operating system on it, and eventually use that to install a new operating system on your machine. Now there are many videos that show you how to do this, but pretty much all of them require you to use something like this, which is Etcher. And Etcher is a software package that will do this pretty much all for you. It's as easy as that animation shows. You just select the file, select the drive, and flash it. Now, that's great, but you have to install it on your machine. And I want to keep my machine as clean as possible. So if there's a way for me to do something without installing anything, that's the way I want to do it. And as it so happens, there is a way to flash ISO images to a USB drive without any third-party software. Now this tutorial is specifically for macOS, so if you use Windows, you'll want to see the other tutorial that I'll post on how to do this with Windows, and for this one we're going to stick with macOS. And we're also going to be using Ubuntu Server. Now, you can download any version here you want, and option 1 and option 2 have some network setup mechanisms for doing it. I'm just going with option 3, which is just the full manual installation. So once you download that, we're going to want to open the terminal, which you can open with, I already have it open, so I'm just showing you there, but you'll open terminal and we're going to need to type in a few commands. If you turn on closed captioning, all of the commands will be written out and they will also be written in order in the description. So the first step is to find out where the USB exists on the machine. And so I'm going to start with the USB unplugged, and I'm going to type in diskutil list. And that's going to list all of the disks that exist on my machine. Now there are two that are built into the Mac operating system, or this machine specifically anyway. And now I'm going to plug in the USB. I'll give it a second. And I'm going to type it again. And now we can see there's a new one. So /dev/disk2, and specifically /dev/disk2. That is where on the machine this USB drive exists. Now that we know where the disk is, we can clean the disk. Now we want to erase all of the data that's already on the disk. If it's a brand new USB, it's still a good idea to run this command just to make sure that everything is nice and clean for our flashing. So we're going to type sudo, and sudo means super user do. So you're going to need administrator access here. If this is your personal computer, then you should be the administrator. Otherwise, you might need to ask whoever owns the machine or is the administrator on it to help you with this, because you'll need to put in the administrator password. And we're going to be using diskutil. From there, we're going to tell it to eraseDisk. And we're going to need to specify a file type, or the partition map. And for this, we're going to be using the file system FAT32. And then we need to specify a new name for the device. So I'm just going to call it Ubuntu. Now we need to give it another format label, so MBRFormat. And then we need to tell it where to do this. So which device are we going to be doing this to? And as we said earlier, we're going to do /dev/disk2. Now here, I should issue a warning that if you do this wrong, you're going to wipe one of your hard drives. So be very careful and make sure you select the correct disk and make sure you type in its address properly. So you need to start with /dev/disk2. And again, it's disk2 for me. It might be something else for you. So be careful when you do this. And we'll run that. I'll type in my password. Run it. It's going to create the partition map, format, and there we go. Now our device should be ready to use. Now that we've cleaned the disk, we need to actually flash the file to it. So for this, we're also going to need sudo. So again, administrator privileges. We're going to use a package called dd, and we're going to specify the block size. And I'm going to set it to 4M. You might need to set it to something different. For my USB, 4M worked well, and it might be different for yours, but try this, and if it doesn't work, do a little research and you'll find what you need. So then we need to specify the input file. So if equals, and now I need to put the path to the file we downloaded. So my Ubuntu ISO file. And the way I'm going to get there is to go to my home directory and then downloads. And then I have the file name on my clipboard, and don't forget the .iso. And then we specify the output file. And if we remember from disk utility, that was /dev/disk2. And it's going to say resources busy. So the problem here is that it's currently mounted on the system. So we need to unmount it. So we'll type in sudo umount /dev/disk2. And again, it's going to say this is not currently mounted. Well, this seems to be conflicting. On the one hand, it thinks it's busy. On the other hand, it thinks it's not mounted on the system. So what we're going to do is we're going to force it to unmount. So we're going to use sudo, and we're going to go back to diskutility. I'm sorry, it's diskutil. And we're going to say unmount disk, and then /dev/disk2. There we go. So now if we hit the up arrow, we can get our command back for flashing the USB. We hit enter, and now it's going to take a long time while it waits to install this. Now, there is no graphical feedback along the way, but trust me, it is actually doing this, and you just need to be patient. So if we just wait a few minutes, it should be done, and we will have a bootable USB. All right, so after about 20 minutes or so, I get this output, and the USB is flashed with the ISO for booting a new operating system. So now I can just unmount the drive and use it however I had intended. So that is an easy way to install a ISO onto a flash drive without any third-party software. Alright, so we all know how this part works. If this video is useful to you, please hit the like button. It helps me grow the channel, and it'll help other people find the video. Also, this is part of a larger project where I'm trying to build a company starting with just 3 old laptops. So if you're interested in seeing how I do that, you can hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to get notifications when I upload a new video. So thank you for watching.